Quick Timeline is a quick tab in QuickShow which lets you create timeline shows where you synchronize the laser effects to music. I recommend expanding this window a lot for when you're working on a timeline in QuickShow. First, you have the menu. Here you can save or open your show, add an audio file. We recommend using WAV files only as they don't have varying bitrate which can cause issues. You can add tracks below for content or effect tracks where you can create effects. Rename a selected track. Add a begin and end time to create loops. Give the show details and author remarks, or just view the remarks. Publish to the cloud and open show properties. In show properties, you can give the show a name and change if the show is measured by seconds or beats, and either set a static BPM for the show or use a system BPM here, which you can vary on the fly. The last option here is for no output at start. So if your show starts with something on, but you want it to be dark before you play, you can click this. Some of these items are also found by right-clicking on the tracks themselves, or by right-clicking on the playhead area here. Along the top, you also have Open and Save. Modes for working in Timeline, select and create, like so. Play and Stop. Here you can select the strength of an event length binding, strong, soft, and none. With this tool, you can zoom to the selected event. Here you can set the marks for the begin and end loop called user time, or manually set the beginning and end with these. With this button, you can see the properties for the selected event on the timeline, where you can give it a name, lock its position, or mute the event so it won't play. You can edit its exact start time and duration, and select the rate of change for the event, where if you have frames, it'll animate the wave between them. You can also select the audio track with this button. And finally, you can publish your work to the Pangolin Cloud if you wish. On the right, you have a button to show it now, which will show what you're working on live on your laser setup. And below that, you have a small preview window for what you're working on, so you can work on the show live and not immediately output to all live lasers. In the main working area of the quick timeline, you have a few things. On the top left, you have the time for where your playhead is. You have the playhead itself, which is where your output is currently, and can be dragged back and forth like so. Below that, you have tracks, which is where you can place laser content, like so. You can right-click on the tracks to add tracks and effect lines, delete tracks, rename tracks, or go to track properties. In track properties, we can rename the track and also assign where we want laser content on this track to go. Without anything assigned, laser content will go to the zone assigned in the cue grid. If you assign a zone or zones here, all content placed on this track will output to that specific zone. This is how you can assign multiple lasers to one track, or make a track specifically for graphics and others for beams. Below that, you can assign your selected tracks to all tracks, or just a number of tracks below to speed it up setup. Once you press OK, it'll be designated to the track to the left. Now let's add some content to our timeline. We can either create completely new content by double-clicking and creating, using the Create tool and dragging out the area you want to create content, or just by dragging content in the workspace to the track like so. Every time content is added to your timeline, 7 main effects are added. These are size, rotation, position, color, brightness, visible points, and scan rate. A lot of things you want to do with the content to make a show you can achieve with these effects. You interact with these effects by double-clicking to create a key. A key is a set value. If you set a key at the beginning for the size of 20, and then set a key at the end for the size of 100, then as the effect plays through, it'll move the laser content between the values like so. You can move them around by clicking and holding them, and you can right-click on the keys to edit the key, delete the key, lock the key's position, as well as copy the key and paste to another part of the effect. Effects are scaled on a percentage, so if you widen this effect's length, the effect will grow with it. If you want more detail here, you can also right-click on the event and go to Edit Event Effect, where you can see more detail on your effects. These effects can also be seen and edited on the Effect tab in the right area of QuickShow if you prefer that interface. You can also add effects to your event here, or right-click on the effects in the event for more options, like adding more effects, copying effects and pasting, deleting or moving the effects order. You can change the view of your timeline by either scrolling in and out on your mouse wheel to scale based on your mouse position, or use the zoom in and out buttons down here, as well as move left and right with this scroll bar here. When you are done creating your show, you can either save it to a file to be loaded up here and played back like so, or you can click and drag the preview window into an empty cell in the grid, so you can have multiple shows built into your workspace. Thank you for watching our Quick Hints video on the Quick Timeline and set of QuickShow. If you still need help, you can contact our support line by emailing support@pangolin.com, and we'll help you as soon as possible.